Not bad. Oh,
let's see. Oh, I like this. Wow. Oh, that's incredible. All right, so this picture that you're looking at right here, this is 18 millimeters on a crop sensor. This is the lower limit of what my old lens could do. Check it. Oh, that's amazing. How about those microphones? See, the bad part about this is now I have to keep my studio cleaner because you can see more of it. This is absolutely incredible. Look at this. This image, I'm holding the camera right now. Look at how far away I look from the camera, but notice I'm just holding it. I solemnly swear that I will at least attempt to not lose the lens cap. Hey everybody, Will Borza here, the LA Recordist. Today we're talking about audio interfaces. So what is an audio interface? An audio interface is a piece of hardware that captures audio signals from microphones and other audio gear and converts those signals into a language that your computer can process. Basically, it takes waveforms and turns it into ones and zeros. The most common computer connection types you can find are USB, FireWire, Lightning, Thunderbolt, and PCI or PCIe cards. And audio connections can range from XLR, TRS, SPDIF, ADAT, DB25, MIDI, and more. Sometimes you can find audio interfaces where the XLR inputs also have microphone preamps. Now, if you have a computer, you technically have an audio interface. It's your audio card. But these cards are not studio grade, and you can't connect the proper cables to them. Your head might just start spinning the first time you look for audio interfaces with all the options out there. The simple truth is that there's no such thing as the best audio interface. The best audio interface for you is the interface that best fits your needs. If you're a singer-songwriter, you'll probably be just fine with a two-input XLR interface. You don't really need more channels than that. But if you're planning on recording bands like Snarky Puppy, you may need upwards of 16 input channels simultaneously. And then if you're an EDM producer, you might need more MIDI inputs than you need audio. If you don't already have microphone preamps, you'll need to get an interface with preamps built in and phantom power for the condenser microphones. And if you're gonna plug in a guitar, bass, or keyboard directly into your interface, you'll want an instrument level input. Those are called Hi-Z. The operating system you work on usually dictates what kind of interface you can use. If you're on a PC, you typically have to stay with PCI or USB. But if you're on a Mac, you could also use Thunderbolt, Lightning, and FireWire. Don't worry too much about speed differences. All these connections are plenty fast to handle large amounts of audio data. All right, so an audio interface on the cheap side, I can recommend no brand higher than Presonus. This is not a paid endorsement, this is just personal experience. I love this interface. It is FireWire only, but it has 8 direct outputs, 8 XLR inputs, Hi-Z alternates on 1 and 2, and 8 preamps. Sounds great, works like a charm. This thing has held up for about a decade now, and I still use it from time to time. Now for mid-range audio interfaces, I wish I had one of these. Unfortunately, I don't. Any of the Universal Audio Apollo series. They look so cool, and I've heard how they sound before. They sound incredible. So if you have a couple extra bucks to spend, but you can't quite afford Pro yet, go with Universal Audio, so good. Now, if you do want to go professional, let me show you something. That guy down there, that's my Apogee Symphony. As far as I've heard, no one makes a better interface than Apogee, and that is their flagship. The first day I got it and plugged it in, it was a revolution. It was amazing. Someday, when you can afford it, when you've made enough money from your songs, you've made enough money from engineering or producing, the Apogee is the dream. The Apogee is the dream. Well guys, that's all I got for today. If you like it, please subscribe. I will see you guys tomorrow. Peace. good news is that I just got a new wide angle. The bad news is now you can see how messy my room is.